Introducing social banking from GT Bank. Anywhere, anytime, any device.
My name is Chude Jidonwo. I'm managing partner, Red Media Africa, which manages brands including WhyNiger.com, the Future Project, the Future Awards, and Red Media. So I say to people that, you know, like I'm an accidental entrepreneur because I never figured that I would run a business, or at least I never figured I would run a business full time. When I came out of school, I worked at Nigeria LNG. And then I worked at Virgin Nigeria as Media Relations Manager Assistant. And we had already started the Future Awards in 2004. I left university in 2006. I was going to get a job. So when I came out, I had got offers from GT Bank to work in the corporate communications department. That meant getting my letter of employment, everything. I just expected this was what I was going to do with my life. Because, you know, and then I thought I would do the Future Awards at the site because I was passionate about young people and the media and Red Strat, which was our company then, and all those things. To do my master's at the Pan-African University in Media and Communication. And so when I left Next and I was going to do my master's, I had an agreement with God. And I said, well, I don't like taking unnecessary risks. I like calculating my risks. So I'm not going to be earning a lot of money doing my master's anyway because it was a full-time program. So I said, God, if the business expands in this 1 year period while I'm doing my master's, then I will take it as a sign that you want me to do it full time. And if the business doesn't work, then I will run back to the people who said, should they come and take a job? I began to work in the media in 2000. I was a presenter on the Sunday show with Livia Jonuma. And then I left and I worked with Insider with Agatha. And then I left and I worked with New Dawn with Fumi and there for 3 years as producer. I met Debola on set Inside Out. Himself and one of my former partners, Emilia, they were doing a show on NTA Network called Youth Talk with Emilia at the night. And I was producing Fumi on that. I was producing Fumi on that show at the time, but I still used to help out with Agatha's show. And then I was also doing a column in This Day called Sons and Daughters. And so Debola came on Inside Out. He was very smart. He was talking. We just serendipity because we sat down together. And so we met again, and he introduced me to Emilia. And I remember that we did a surprise birthday party for Fumi Yonder at the time. She was turning 33, so. And Adebola and Emilia helped me organize the event. And it was amazing, you know. And, you know, we saw each other's strengths. Adebola can talk to anybody anywhere, you know, he can. He's an amazing ambassador for anything he's doing. Emilia was more the structure person, and I was more the creative person, and also had a lot of contacts. So we thought, how do we marry our ideas? You know, we sat down in front at the back of a play at Muson Center, I remember, and that was when we said, look, let's do the Future Award. We're discussing how do we marry sons and daughters, youth talk, and how do we use the media to engage our generation? And we thought, that's where the idea, that's how we met, and that's how we began to work together in 2004. I started my business with zero naira. We didn't even have an account when we started this business. We had our personal funds. If this thing is going to work, then it's going to pay for itself. It's going to create value for itself. We're going to generate funds. So we literally, and that doesn't mean that we got support. We got, the first few hours got support from a lot of amazing people, but we didn't have money when we went to them. We went with them with an idea, and we had a lot of contacts that we had already met through the media, you know. And those were the things that helped us. I'm a firm believer in people. I believe more if I get $1 million, I invest it in employing more people than in getting a bigger space or something. You know, because I know the power of people. You know, I know the power of the human capacity to create. And I've seen it in action. It's not a proposal I wrote. It's something that I had to. If it hadn't worked out, then we wouldn't have a business worth speaking about now. I mean, from zero naira, I worked in a multi-million dollar business. I say that because I'm proud of it. It's fulfilling to know that you can do something. You know, I always say that we have survived in Nigeria. Our story is a tale that much is possible in Nigeria by Nigerians, in spite of Nigeria. People always say you need a godfather, you need a rich parent, you need connections, you need a note. None of my jobs, when I went to sit down in GT Bank with the head of corporate, the GM of corporate communication at the time, nobody gave me a note. to her. It was just when I went to meet Professor Padatomi and said, become chairman of our board, nobody gave me a note. You know, so to see that, to see my own story and to watch it, you know, and to see, you know, Wine Magazine got the only exclusive interview with Mr. President, you know, to see the range of clients we've worked for, Google, the British Council, the US government. You know, sometimes it things like, it seems like, you know, I'm always panicking because I can't believe it sometimes. Like, with each success, I'm afraid that it's going to all unravel, you know, because, you know, but we work so hard. So it's been great, but also it's been rewarding because of the kind of work we do. I began to do it full time 3 years ago, but then at least it's a 9-year-old business. It's not a short time because I don't believe that anything good comes out of a short process. I believe that anything good comes out of a process that cannot be short-circuited. Nigeria is a challenge, you know, which is why people say I'm so passionate about doing things to help, to do things for my country, because, you know, the challenges we face here, I mean, we just incorporated one of our companies in the UK, and within 2 weeks, I had my registration documents, my checkbook, the government had already gone to give me, gone to get me an account, everything was done, there was a lawyer asking for an appointment with me for 1 hour to come and discuss my new business. And I let Chineke God, you know, to register Red Media took us 1 year, you know, of name rejection, going to, we employing a lawyer, going to Abuja to CAC, going to see minister for exemption, all kinds of funny things. You know, so Nigeria is just a difficult place, you know, and in 2 weeks in the UK, I had gotten my company and I thought, wow. You know, so, you know, I don't want to lament. You only need to go to Twitter and see all the problems, you know, but Nigeria is a challenge for anybody who wants to run a business without even going into specifics of wealth, generator space, you know, or the taxation. You know, because we in this company pay all the taxes. Everything that they bring, we pay. Even industrial training, one funny tax that doesn't add any value to anybody. And you wonder, a government that doesn't give its people support to run their business in terms of institutions, I'm not talking about grants, which are great, but institutional support. Why do you take so much? You take VAT, you take personal income tax, you take, you don't take going on the road tax. If I don't put my signboard, you come and take tax. You know, it's just incredible the kind of society, but it is what it is. Those are the three major challenges that I see. One of the traits that I found to be integral to our success, relentlessness. So I always tell people about this picture on my office wall. That moment of victory, I capture that picture and I have it in my office every day. To remind me that if you don't stop, you can break through. So yes, so Hillary is not a business person, but she captures the whole idea of relentlessness perfectly. You know, I don't rest until something has achieved full potential. I don't rest until I've tried every single possibility that it cannot work. And even then, I still blame myself. That after I've tried every possibility and it doesn't work, I say today, there's something you did not do. Right, maybe because you're limited in knowledge, maybe because you're limited in resources, maybe because you don't know where to go. But really, I think relentlessness is so important for life, for everything. For I know, and that's how I run my business. I don't know any other way. You know, it makes me a difficult person. So obviously, it makes me too hard. You know, whatever. But that's all I know. And I believe that if you see something is possible, you don't stop until it actually happens.